And still ahead on Action News at 4, the numbers are in. Find out if Prime Day bargains turned into a big win for Amazon.
And America's closest ally has new leadership today. Details on the resignation of David Cameron and the woman who is now taking his place.
And it's been a decade-long battle in South Jersey, but today, people who fought to keep their homes not only got to stay, they cut the ribbon on a major upgrade. The change of power is now complete in Britain. David Cameron stepped down as Prime Minister today. He left earlier than planned following Britain's vote to leave the European Union. Queen Elizabeth accepted Cameron's resignation at Buckingham Palace, and a short time later, the Queen invited Theresa May to become the new leader. May promised to guide Britain through its divorce with the EU.
We will make Britain a country that works not for a privileged few, but for every one of us. That will be the mission of the government I lead, and together we will build a better Britain.
May delivered that address outside her new home at the Prime Minister's residence on Downing Street.
Well, today a big moment for families who have been waiting years to move into their new homes in their old neighborhood. This is all part of a redevelopment of the Mount Holly Gardens neighborhood and the neighbors who fought for their right to stay and won. Elida Echevarria is wiping away tears as she stands in her brand new kitchen. Happy tears, emotions, decades in the making. You see, Elida and her son Louis have been living in Mount Holly Gardens for 21 years, and their new home marks the first time each of them will have their own bedroom.
For first time I see what my first room cannot have before a room.
They're one of three families moving into their brand new homes today, and it's all part of a landmark lawsuit they filed against the township back in 2002. This is the Mount Holly Gardens they used to live in. Developers were looking to knock down the blighted development to make way for new projects. But residents argued that amounted to discrimination, and they won 3 years ago. Today, they cut the ribbon on the groundbreaking result. Brand new homes built just for them.
The historic settlement that was the successful culmination of many parties coming together with a solution that offered improved housing and overall quality of living for our residents.
And these homes are just the first of many as part of a bigger development project that includes 44 residences, 17 of them replacement homes for other plaintiffs in that lawsuit.
We needed to make it right for the residents that were still remaining down here to have a new home in the neighborhood that they wish to stay in. And the neighborhood is going to turn around to be a positive effect on this town.
And today the families say they're just happy that they got to stay in their neighborhood, saying goodbye to their old rundown homes and moving into those brand new homes they say they've only dreamed of. Brian.
All right, great stuff. Alicia, thank you. Amazon says yesterday was the single biggest day of sales in that company's history. The retailer held its second annual Prime Day, a shopping holiday it created last year to increase sales in the